In 1948, George Gomov came up with another idea concerning the Big Bang. He stated that after the formation of the universe by a big explosion, a radiation surplus should have existed in the universe left over from this explosion. Moreover, this radiation ought to be uniformly diffused across the universe. This evidence, which ought to have existed, was soon to be found. In 1965, two researchers by the name of Arno Penzias and Robert Wilson discovered these waves by chance. This radiation, called the cosmic background radiation, did not seem to radiate from a particular source, but rather pervaded the whole of space. Thus, it was understood that this radiation was left over from the initial stages of the Big Bang. Penzias and Wilson were awarded a Nobel Prize for their discovery. In 1989, NASA sent the Cosmic Background Explorer, COBE satellite, into space to do research on cosmic background radiation. It took only 8 minutes for COBE to verify Penzias and Wilson's calculations. The COBE had found the remains of the big explosion that had taken place at the outset of the universe. Defined as the greatest astronomic discovery of all times, this finding explicitly proved the Big Bang theory. Another important piece of evidence for the Big Bang was the amount of hydrogen and helium in space. In the researches, it was understood that the hydrogen-helium concentration in the universe complied with the theoretical calculations of the hydrogen-helium concentration remaining from the Big Bang. If the universe had no beginning, and if it had existed since eternity, its hydrogen constituent should have already been completely consumed and converted to helium. All of this compelling evidence caused the Big Bang theory to be embraced by the scientific community. The Big Bang model was the latest point reached by science concerning the origin of the universe. Defending the steady-state theory alongside Fred Hoyle for years, Dennis Sciama described the final position they had reached after all the evidence for the Big Bang theory was revealed. Sciama stated that he had defended the steady-state theory, not because he deemed it valid, but because he wished that it were valid. Sciama goes on to say that as evidence began to pile up, he had to admit that the game was over and that the steady-state theory had to be dismissed. Professor George Abel from the University of California also accepts the ultimate victory of the Big Bang and states that currently available evidence shows that the universe originated billions of years ago with the Big Bang. He concedes that he has no choice but to accept the Big Bang theory. With the Big Bang's victory, the myth of eternal matter that constituted the basis of the materialist philosophy is thrown into the trash heap of history. What then was before the Big Bang? And what was the power that brought the universe into being with this big explosion when it was non-existent? This question certainly implies, in Arthur Eddington's words, the philosophically repugnant fact for the materialists, that is, the existence of a creator. The renowned atheist philosopher Anthony Flew comments on the issue. Notoriously, confession is good for the soul. I will therefore begin by confessing that the Stratonician atheist has to be embarrassed by the contemporary cosmological consensus. For it seems that the cosmologists are providing a scientific proof that the universe had a beginning. Many scientists who do not blindly condition themselves to be atheists have admitted the role of an almighty creator in the creation of the universe. This creator must be a being who has created both matter and time, yet who is independent of both. Well-known astrophysicist Hugh Ross has this to say. If time's beginning is concurrent with the beginning of the universe, as the space theorem says, then the cause of the universe must be some entity operating in a time dimension completely independent of and pre-existent to the time dimension of the cosmos. This conclusion tells us that God is not the universe itself, nor is God contained within the universe.